My name is Will Mahoney-Watson. I am a PCC instructor in the CAS department. And today we're going to talk about wireframes. And what is a wireframe? A wireframe is basically a structural outline of all the elements that are going to go into your web page designs. And today we're going to create a wireframe for the smartphone, tablet, and desktop layouts. Now, the most important thing about wireframes is the content. Content is king. So we've talked to our client, and in this case we're going to use the CAS 206 client, Portland Historical Tours. We've talked to the client, and the client has indicated to us that these are the most important issues for them. So we're going to try to make sure that these are displayed roughly in this order. So obviously the first thing you need is a logo that says the name of your client. The second thing is some kind of navigation, obviously. The client has created a video, and he thinks that this video displays the content of their tours in a very professional manner, so they really want to emphasize this video. Right underneath the video should come the schedule, so viewers can see the upcoming schedule, and then clearly they want to sign up for that upcoming tour. On the side, they're willing to have some facts about Portland to kind of draw the viewer into the interesting things that they're going to see on these tours. And of course, they also want to have some social media icons, and at the bottom, a footer with some basic information. So these are the content references that we want to have in our wireframe. Now what we're going to do is lay them into HTML structural elements. So obviously with the logo name, we're going to put that in the header. The nav obviously goes in the nav. Then we start our main content, and then we're going to have an article for the video and an article for the schedule. And we can keep this article, the schedule, and the sign up together in one article. And then we're going to put the facts in a side or a sidebar, and we can include our social media in the sidebar as well. And finally, we're going to have a footer. So those are the structural elements we're going to lay out. So for the purposes of this class, we're going to set breakpoints, and we're going to say that anything under 481 pixels is a smartphone. So we're going to use progressive enhancement by laying out our design first for the smartphone in a mobile-first environment. Then we're going to lay out the tablet, and then finally the desktop. And you may think that a smartphone screen is limited to this tiny little box. But in reality, we always scroll with smartphones. So this bottom box border isn't really here. I'd like to think of it more as a long scrolling layout. And it's very difficult to put two columns in a smartphone and make them large enough to be usable. So pretty much we have to lay out everything as 100% content. So we're going to start out with our logo, or our header, I'm sorry. And then under that, we'll have our little nav section, and we might use a little hamburger here to create that compressed menu for our smartphone. Then we can start our main here, and then we'll have our first article with the video here, our second article with the schedule and sign up here. Then we have to put our side at the bottom, and then finally, we can have our footer at the bottom. So that's the basic layout for our smartphone. Now, for the purposes of this class, we're also going to say that a tablet is anything between 1024 pixels and 481 pixels. So this is part of that progressive enhancement, where now we can take what we've laid out in the smartphone and lay it out in a desktop or a tablet. And so again, we're also in the same way not limited to just the size of the tablet, because we can scroll in a tablet as well. But we can now break out our columns into wider sections. So we could have a full width header, and we can have a full width nav too, with the individual buttons there. And now we can bring in an aside. We can have our content for the aside structured on one side of the page, and then we can have our articles here. So we have article, aside, and footer. So that's a tablet. The real fun gets to the desktop then, when we start laying out a much larger grid. And for the most part, people nowadays use the 12-point grid system. And what that means is that I can take my grid and lay it out into 12 equally divisible cubes, and then I can use any combination of those 12 cubes. And we use 12 because 12 is divisible by 2, 3, 4, and 6. So that gives us the most combinations possible to provide some real interesting layouts. So we could still start with our full page header and our full page nav. But now we can start structuring things in different sized grids. So for example, I could split this grid evenly into two even sized six grid sections. I could put it into three evenly sized sections. I could use four evenly sized sections. Or I could use any combination of those. So I can have three, six, three, or even 12 tiny little things if I wanted. Generally, that's not going to be too effective. But if I need a lot of little pictures, I can use them. So you can see how using the 12-point grid can allow you to create all kinds of interesting layouts using the structural elements that we first started with in the smartphone, enhanced in the tablet, and then can really expand on in the desktop. So the trick is now taking these templates, these wireframes, and creating them into templates. And what is a template? A template is the HTML and CSS and any other code you might need to create a working web page that uses this design. And then when that template is created, we can then use that template to duplicate and create the rest of the pages for our website. So that's how you take content into a wireframe, into a template.